In this video, I'm going to show you how easy it is to play all of your 2D Steam games in virtual reality on the Mirage Solo using the Steam Link app and how well it actually works. All coming up. Hi and welcome to MRTV. My name is Sebastian Ang, and if this is your first time here, and if you're just as excited about VR and AR as I am, then subscribe now and click on the bell button so you don't miss anything. As you know, I'm working on the in-depth MRTV review of the Lenovo Mirage Solo. Now, in the scope of this review process, I checked out how easy it is and how well it works to play 2D Steam games in virtual reality on the Mirage Solo using the Steam Link Android app. Because as you know, you can play any Android app on the Mirage Solo. Now, I can tell you it works flawlessly. It's great. And you can even use your PlayStation 4 controller, for example. And you do that by simply plugging it in into the USB-C port here. And you can do so by using an OTG adapter, like this one, for example, which came with the Galaxy S8 of my wife. So I simply plugged it in and it works flawlessly. But now, enough of the talking. Let me show you how well it works and how to set it up. Yeah, so this is the great thing with the Mirage Solo. You can install any Android app and you simply go to the Google Play Store and make sure that you're logged in with the same account as on your Mirage Solo. Now, simply look for any Android app. Now, in this case, I'm looking for Steam Link. And, well, here it is. The Steam Link app comes up. Now, I've already installed it, but for you, simply click on the green button, Install, and now it shows you a list of your devices. Now look for the Lenovo Mirage Solo. It's here on second place, but I've already installed it, so it's grayed out. But for you, simply click it. And the next thing that's gonna happen, it will show you that the Steam Link app is going to be installed on your Mirage Solo, and that's really it. And that's how it works for all Android apps and games. So now how to start the app. From the home screen, click on the Daydream button, like now. Then click on Settings. Here, click on All Settings. Now go to Apps and Notifications and find Steam Link. And here it is, click on it. Scroll down to App Details and here click on Open. And here it is. Now at this time I had already plugged in my PS4 controller. So here you can see my MSI laptop and here you can see my PS4 controller. And it seems like I have a fair connection. Now simply click on Start Playing and it's going to connect to your Steam computer, and here it is. Yes, the big screen version of Steam. And you can scroll around with your PS4 controller or any controller that you've connected to your Mirage Solo. Now this here is my library, and I don't have so many 2D games anymore, but this is BioShock. Let's play it for a while. Now, the cool thing here is that using the menus and everything, actually, there's a very, very little latency. So it's actually much better than playing that in big screen on the Oculus Go. This is really, really no comparison at all. This is so fluid and simply works great with nearly no latency. Actually, when playing games, you cannot feel the latency. It's just so good, and especially to have that in VR is fascinating. Now in this video, you don't hear the game sound, but rest assured, you do hear the game sound when you actually play this using the Mirage Solo. Just now in this recording, you don't hear it because I'm using a recording method that does not record audio. Now that is bad, and I'm going to improve that in the future and definitely will also record audio. So the audio is just as if you would be playing on the Steam machine yourself. And again, what I found so cool is that the PS4 controller was simply recognized by the Steam Link app. Simply plug it in and it will show PS4 controller. You don't have to do any calibrations or anything. Everything just directly works like a charm. So if you have any controller that is compatible with Steam, then it should also work with the Steam Link app, and that is so convenient. Yeah, so here you have it. You can play all of your Steam 2D games in VR. And what's cool now, you know, let me go close to the screen because, well, that's what 6 degrees of freedom are for. Yeah, so I simply move closer to the screen if I want to have it even bigger. Now, that is really one of the great things about 6 degrees of freedom. You can simply move around in your room. You can move back, move forward if you want to have a bigger screen. And yeah, that is really one big advantage over the Oculus Go, where you only have 3 degrees of freedom and unfortunately no way to use the Steam Link app on the Oculus Go, even if you try to sideload the app. Hopefully that will be possible in the future, and once this becomes an option on the Oculus Go, I will definitely show you a tutorial here as well, how to play Steam games on the Oculus Go. At the moment you can do so using the big screen app, but unfortunately there's quite a latency and it's totally not comparable to how well this works here on the Mirage Solo. Yeah, so the Lenovo Mirage Solo does have quite some tricks up its sleeve, and it's so cool that you can play all Android apps in virtual reality now. And you know what? I even connected my wireless keyboard to the Lenovo Mirage Solo using that OTG adapter. And well, then you can use Gmail, you can use Word in virtual reality, and that is all pretty cool. So definitely you can look forward to the full review, to the full MRTV review of the Lenovo Mirage Solo, which is coming up here on the channel very, very soon. But that's it for this video. If you have any more questions, please do leave them in the comment section below, or much better, why don't you directly chat with me and the MRTV community on the MRTV Discord server. The MRTV Discord server is a great free resource that lets you chat with like-minded people, with me, with the MRTV community, and it's totally free. You can find the link in the description below. But that's it for this video. If you enjoyed it and if it was helpful for you, please give it a thumbs up. And of course, if you have not yet subscribed to MRTV, do so now. I'm looking forward to see you in the next episode.